Somalia hosted its annual partnership forum on Monday. In attendance were all of the leaders of the federal member states, as well as key international partners. James Swan represented the United Nations as the head of UNSOM. Keynote address was given by Prime Minister Mohamed Roble. He focused his attention primarily on the elections and the country's drive for economic reforms.
The electoral agreement recently reached between the federal government of Somalia and the federal member states on indirect elections marked the culmination of the political agreement that will also safeguard the 30% women quota and guide the implementation of the upcoming elections.
Prime Minister assured his audience that the government has a plan to ensure universal suffrage in 2024-2025. When it came time to talk about economics, Roble named implementation of the National Development Plan, NDP-9, as the key issue. He also promised to fulfill responsibilities to the International Monetary Fund to achieve debt forgiveness.
We are determined to remain on the right reform trajectory to reach the completion point and hopefully attain complete debt forgiveness. This should lead Somalia on the road to sustainable development, progress, and prosperity.
Roble's speech met with general goodwill from the audience. The head of the African Union mission in Somalia, AMISOM, praised the election agreement. Francisco Madeira also highlighted the importance of Somalia's constitutional review process. When it was Swan's turn to speak, he had praise for the many accomplishments of the administration of President Mohamed Farmajo. But he pleaded for urgent consultations to sort out the many issues that appear to be standing in the way of conducting the coming polls. The European Union's representative, Nicolas Berlanga, seconded Swan's wishes. He also appeared to warn politicians not to use language that is destructive to the process of getting the balloting underway.
Leaders should meet, and leaders should agree and use the Somali way of solving problems with key and words and try to overcome the small difficulties.
Puntland's President Said Deni brought up contentious issues when it was his turn to speak. Deni called on federal troops to leave the Gedo region in Jubaland. And he asked that the Somaliland Electoral Committee be inclusive of all segments of society from the breakaway state. Prime Minister Roble also stressed the need for security cooperation with international partners to continue. And he thanked the partners for their help in fighting the COVID-19 pandemic.
Excellencies and colleagues, through our Somali state building process, we agreed to work together to build and invest in Somalia's future. Today, Somali Partnership Forum offers a concrete opportunity to deliver this commitment to do our part in building our country.
Africa Digital News Television, ADN-TV, brings you the latest developments from Somalia, Africa, and across the globe.